Hey there, I'm Summer Hill 7, and I'm an actor, and today I want to talk to you about applying for your MFA. I know thousands of you out there right now are preparing and thinking about your monologues for your MFA programs, your interviews, your applications, your essays, etc. And so I just want to slow the process down for you in some ways and get you thinking outside of the boxes that are even outside the other boxes that you're getting outside of, because ultimately all of it is the universe itself is a box. And so we want to continue to unveil and reveal things that help us to continue to manifest our own destiny. And that's what this conversation is about, vis-a-vis applying for an MFA in acting in particular. Brian O'Neill, who is a well-known acting career consultant and a audition coach, said that there are 7 reasons that people go and receive their MFAs, and all the applications will ask you why. Why do you want to do this? Why do you want to do it? He said these are the top 7 reasons. Number 1, to polish one's craft. Number 2, to gain credibility. 3, to get representation. 4, to be considered seriously for paid acting jobs in the theater. 5, to strengthen the resume. 6, broaden contacts. 7, financial appeal. All but one of these relate to how other people see you. And that's half the picture, right? Half of our existence is on the outside, the things that people can see. And certainly as actors, that's how we will be evaluated, based on what they see on the outside, as well as what is unseen that we allow to escape. So consequently, we also have to work on the internal. And so what I'd like to share with you are my own 7 tips based on my own experience. And if you don't know my story, I'll give it to you real quick. When I was 5 years old, a lady asked me in front of my mother, what do you want to be when you grow up? And I said, I'm going to be a pimp. And my mother, she grabbed my hand and looked at the lady and said, no, he's going to be a lawyer. Cut to 20 years later, after I passed the bar, I'm sitting in California in a movie theater after having watched Spike Lee's movie Malcolm X, and trying to figure out what is it I really want to do with my life. And I figured out that all I ever really wanted to do was be a whole bunch of different things. And so I became an actor, and I've been an actor for 25 years, and eventually I completed my MFA at the University of Delaware, but I was also previously in another MFA program at SUNY Binghamton, and admitted to a program at Northern Illinois University. So I have some perspective that's broader than just a one-time applicant and then going through MFA. So that's what my tips are based on, this broader perspective of having been a professional actor both before going to get an MFA and after. The first tip is to know yourself on what I call a quadrant 3 level. the four quadrants. One is things that you know about you and that we know about you, like your height, your weight, the things we can see and observe, all those things that we talk about on the outside. Quadrant two are the things that only you know and we don't know. Like maybe what kind of underwear you have on right now, or that piece of candy you stole when you were a little girl and you got away with it and never told anybody. Those secrets that you keep exclusively to yourself. And then quadrant three is the things that other people know that you don't know. Like you'll never really be able to see actually the back of your head. You can see pictures of it, you can see videos of it. And then there are quirks and things that we do, like when we say and that your director, your coach, whoever is coaching you in your audition process can help you with. That's the things, that's what the director's job is, to see those quadrant three things that we don't see about ourselves as actors, but that they see. So when I say know yourself on a quadrant three level, that means know yourself both through your own eyes and through the eyes of those people that know your work carefully. That's tip number one. Tip number two. You have to love yourself on a quadrant four level. Now, the fourth quadrant I did not mention is the things that nobody knows and they happen when we're together. For instance, I'm making this video right now in some particular time and day, and you may watch it on some other particular time of day. Both will happen now and the experience will be a what I call a quadrant four, unique to that
just
moment
like
experience.
Says your favorites from yesterday and today.
Love yourself on a quadrant four level. Love yourself now, all the time, under every circumstance, completely. The things you know about yourself, the things you don't know about yourself. When you know, it's in the language, you see. And tip number three covers this. Name yourself. Because it's in the language, it's in the words that come out of your mouth, what these tips are relating to. For example, practice introducing yourself. Your name may be, let's say, William Midiette. Okay? Now, you might want to be called Bill. Or you might have a middle name. Think about that and practice that on a regular basis every time you do your piece and do it for real. One of my acting coaches used to say, mean it more. Mean it. And that's kind of about as clear as it is. Mean it. You mean it. So that's name yourself and prepare how you're going to do your introduction. That's all a part of creating your own identity. It's perhaps another way of saying name yourself. Four, tip number four. Imagine yourself as a graduate of the institution at the audition. Use your powers of imagination that actors do. We do, you know, we play murderers, but we don't all have to kill people to do that. We do that with our imagination. Use that same, you know, colossal mechanism to imagine yourself as an alumni coming back to audition as by way of demonstration of how wonderful of an actor you have become even after you left. I discovered this actually in my audition at the University of Delaware. On the final day of the audition, I wore to the school a Delaware shirt as if to say, it was already a foregone conclusion, that I'm a graduate of this institution. So now what do you want to talk about? That was my approach at the last day of the audition. Because I'd already been to two MFA programs. So I wasn't really fazed by MFA. You know, it didn't really, like, it was really for me about who were the people I was going to be spending the next 3 years of my valuable, precious life with. And so I think in this tip number four, it gets you out of thinking, do they like me, do they like me, like all these six reasons that Brian O'Neill talked about, and it gets you in the mindset of, do I like them? So that's tip four. Tip five. Live your audition material. As an actor, I loathe the word memorize. I don't memorize lines. I haven't memorized lines for decades. I become the lines. Take it how you want to, I'm telling you what I do. Memorization is a poor substitute for being. I think if we think about that in our own lives, you know, would you rather memorize making love to someone or make love to someone? Would, you know, you want to sense memory it or you want to do it? If you had to choose between the two. And that's really the difference between being. And so when I talk about living your audition material, spend time with it, really examine it, sleep with it, be in it. In your imagination. Step six. This is now going into the environment of the actual audition. Plug into the audition environment immediately. As soon as you get into the room, the building, contact with them, go to a place of stillness, okay? Find that stillness, talk about that with your coach, your director, if you're not clear about what that means, but find your neutral, and then plug into the energy that's going on there. I can tell you about two experiences from two different graduate schools. First one, SUNY Binghamton. To go to the audition, one-on-one audition. I'd already been to Yale, NYU. I go in, I do two monologues. They loved me. Immediately after I finished, they offered me a full scholarship right there in the room. And I all but accepted right there in the room. I didn't have any, you know, I wasn't doing, you know what I mean, why not? That's one. The other, I found out 5 minutes before the audition, on a very cold winter day in New York City, windy day, I walked literally 12 blocks or 10 blocks to the audition, got the application, the quick meet and greet, come back the next day for the full-blown audition. Completely different energies, completely different person that I was. So what I learned was to be find my zero, my neutral, and plug into, in other words, follow direction, really understand what it is they were asking of me, and then give them me doing it. I don't know if that makes any sense. 7. And final tip. Touch on it a little bit in 6. Locate and create from nothing. You know, we used to joke that at our school, you know, I went to 3 years of graduate school and acting, and all I got was nothing. Because ultimately, that's where creation is. The climate for creation is ripe from the empty space of nothing. You know, the moment you put something there, you have created something. And so tip 7 is about, you know, all the other things that you're thinking about, application fees, and, you know, how you're gonna get to New York to audition, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. In the space, you know, I learned yesterday that only 5% of the entire vast universe is matter. 95% of it is empty space. And I think that is a lesson for us to continue to find that nothing, that empty space in us, and create from that every time. Now, when you meet people, be there. When you're alone, be there. As you watch this video, be there. So again, here are the 7 tips. I'm just gonna review them real quick. Number 1, know yourself on a quadrant 3 level. 2, love yourself on a quadrant 4 level. 3, name yourself. Number 5, live your audition material. I skipped 1. 3, name yourself. 4, imagine yourself as a graduate at the audition. 5, live your audition material. 6, plug into the audition environment. And 7, locate and create from nothing.